as a young person. You watch NFL players playing the game, and you want to one day achieve those sort of things and play at those levels.
Christian Gonzalez.
To be able to represent Columbia really means a lot to me.
That has to mean something.
Elijah Vera Tucker.
That I'm one of the few representatives of Mexican culture in the NFL.
I don't have that on my shoulders, but I like having that on my shoulders for sure.
I'd like to start off by saying that single-handedly for an industry that Bill Gaithers has done more for.
Gaither.
Well, that's really not my fault, because, you know, up to about 4 months ago, I couldn't tell the difference between Bill Gaither and Bob Vila. I didn't know. You understand.
Yes.
I know one of them builds pianos and the other destroys.
Always a magic guy, good job is.
Now, Bill.
But we're not here to honor him.
No, we're not. Bill Gaither. Is Gaither?
Gaither.
Bill Gaither. He's totally dedicated to gospel music. He's the only guy I know that wants his natural hair to look like a wig.
And he's successful at it.
Yeah, he's good at it. He's good at it.
Why do you have so much humor in your concerts?
You know what? We have done that from the beginning. A lot of people think I just started with Mark Lowry. That was not true.
Well, it got good.
I was the first Mark Lowry.
It got really sharp.
We took it to another level.
Yes,
when you came.
Well, another level.
I can remember in the early days with the trio, well, even before Gloria came along, when Danny and Gloria and Marianne and I go to churches, I would say, "We're glad to be here." I said, "This is my little sister. She's 11 years old." And this is my brother Danny. He's 16 years old, or 17 years, 18, but then 18 years old. And I'm his brother Bill. A lot of people ask if Danny's married, and the answer is no. And there'd be a little pause and a little chuckle, and I'd say, "And I'm not either." And there'd be a bigger laugh then, you know. And it really started there to really realize that if you were going to be able to feed some serious ideas to a crowd, you had to some way make friends with them and do it with humor. And then later on, when we got together, there was quite a bit of humor. I remember the lines like, "How many of you thought your mom liked your brother better than she liked you?" And they raised hands. "How many of you knew your mother liked your brother better than she liked you?" There'd be more, some more hands raised, and more, a bigger laugh, you know. "How many of your mothers told you she liked your brother better than..." And it would lead into this song, "I'm Something Special." Humor has always been a way to get defenses down, because people kind of come in, I think, with some walls. And it's a way to knock some walls down to say, "Hey, we got something serious you want to say." And people often say to me, "How's Mark Lowry to live with on the bus?" Well, for crying out loud, if they're thinking he's like he is on the stage all the time on a bus, he's one of the most serious young men I know. He's a very caring person. He's a very charitable person. I'm tearing you up here. But the humor is a technique for you to communicate to people that God loves them and cares about them and thinks they're
very... And people can't laugh with their arms folded.
They can't.
They've got to bring their arms down.
I think it's very important that we take God very seriously. And I think it's very important that we take ourselves a whole lot less seriously. We're not God. We're just parents. We're just wives. We're just people.
And
I think a lot of times we take ourselves too seriously and don't take God seriously enough.
And when people write me and say, "You know, when you make that joke about hair, there are people who have got balding problems." Well, join the club. I've got a balding problem. And Danny has a balding problem. And when you say something about Bill's weight or your weight, or people got weight, join the club.
Just don't say anything about mine. Just hush.
I mean, we all have those problems. And to get them out and laugh about them, or stuttering or not being able to think fast enough, let's laugh about them. Celebrate them. It's part of our humanity. Give them to the Lord and have a good time.
But I can remember one of the things that we did to see if our new songs were any good or not. We'd mimeograph off one of our new songs at work or at school during the week. Just stay with me. I'm going to... I'm circling the field. That's... It doesn't mean I'm going to land, but I could come in any time. So you just get your seat. Laura and I were both teaching school. She was a French teacher, and I was teaching English down the hall at the high school there at home. I hadn't met her yet, but I was excited about meeting her. Not as excited as she was about meeting me, but...
I remember you had that funny-looking haircut.
Yeah, that wasn't funny. It was a crew cut.
It was funny. It looked kind of like a suede bowling ball. No, really what happened is you asked me if I'd like to go to lunch.
In fact, we went out about
every day for
about 2 weeks.
2 or 3 weeks. Yeah. We had the nicest talks. Yeah. And after a couple of weeks, I thought she's getting to like me. Because then that one day, you offered to pay for lunch. So we went to the restaurant, and the lady brought the menus, and she opened them and put them in front of us, and I noticed Bill closed his right away, and he said, I think I'll just have a grilled cheese. What will you just have? I knew there was charm and wit buried under there someplace.
How right you were.
And humility. You know, and then when we start dating, we start dating pretty seriously then, and I about the time I thought I couldn't live without you, remember, I had to go home for the whole summer.
That was really hard on you.
Yeah, it was. I had a really good job at home, and I needed the money for my senior year.
Tell him what you did.
It was a really good job.
Tell him what you did, Gloria.
I worked at Kellogg's in Battle Creek.
Tell him what you did at Kellogg's in Battle Creek. Go on, tell him what you did, Gloria.
I picked the burnt cornflakes off the conveyor belt.
And if he sees that little sparrow.
That's a big bird come through here. I know, but a bird came through and nearly landed in your nest.
No, no.
Don't mess up my song, okay?
I didn't do it.
Yes, you did.
No, I did not.
I heard you do it. You did it.
He did it.
Me?
Yeah. You can be replaced. I can wear that wig.
I'm gonna keep on singing and telling folks about you.